ignored thing, that is having water. Because only and only when we feel thirsty, that's the time when we actually realize that we want to have water. But that's the time when your body is actually dehydrating. So keep yourself hydrated. All these things, no matter how simple they might sound to you, but really makes a lot of difference in the way you feel, in the way you look. And let me tell you something, that don't fake it. As in, your personality can never be, you don't want to develop a fake persona. Be original, be a masterpiece, all of you are. And in students of IIT, oh my god, so many people take you as role models. So many people look up to you. So you deserve, and you need to portray an image where actually you prove them right. So thank you so much, and let me know if you have any questions. Yeah. How to tackle stress? Okay. See, exercising is one of the best ways to deal with stress, because when you're really angry or when you're really sad, I think that's one of the best sessions at the gym you can have. So there are people who actually, when they're sad, what they do, they eat. So we're not a dog, you know, you're not a dog. Don't feed yourself when you're angry. Go to the gym and work out. So that is one. Second thing is, you have to develop a hobby which you like. And if you got recently you've got pocket money, then you can go out and spend. Enjoy your time. That way it will help you reduce your stress. But then think about your parents too, even they might have stress.
Excuse me. Depending.
Are you Somesh? Somesh Gupta?
Okay. How a person plans his fitness regime depending upon the body he has, the problem he or she has.
Okay, how do you plan your fitness regime, right?
Yeah.
See, the first thing that you should understand is that whether you are, see, first of all, you have to check, for example, how many minutes can you walk, the basic tests that VO2 max and all, but that you can do on your own. Or for instance, you can take a talk test on your own when you're walking. But then you can check that whether I'm able to speak while I'm walking, what is my pace? Is it, should I push myself? This is the one way where you can understand the pace of your walking. That is one. The second thing is that if you've never exercised, then you should always take baby steps while going here. So you start with walking, then you include jogging, and then slowly and gradually you should always do weight training. But mind you that once, if you're new to weight training, then you should always consult a personal trainer or a trainer who can guide you. Otherwise, you can have injuries, right?
Well, it means if I'm a novice at exercising, so I should always
start. Can I come again?
If I'm a novice at exercising. So I should always start with cardio. Then I should move ahead.
See, why cardio? Because your body gets into the habit of exercising. Just maybe for a week, then obviously you should do weight training, because the result that you really want, only weight training can give you. But as a beginner, as a novice, you should start with cardio, get used to it, start with jogging, and then you should start lifting weights. That way you will see results.
Thanks.
Yeah?
Yes?
Ma'am, what should I do if I'm underweight?
Okay. Want to reduce weight, ask me, so you should be happy. If you want to increase your weight, then number one, you have to create a calorie surplus. That is, you have to eat more of calories but not a lot of fat. That is not the simple carbs like chocolates, ice cream, pastries. You should, for instance, if you're a non-vegetarian, then you should eat chicken, fish, all those sort of things. And then you should exercise, you should lift heavy weights. And I'll tell you one more thing, for all those of you who are vegetarians or who are into exercising, you have to take enough protein every day. Now how do you understand this? How do you understand what is enough protein? For instance, if your weight is 60 kg, then you should take at least 60 grams of protein every day. Because every day, the reason being that our body doesn't store protein as it stores carbohydrates and fat. So if you really want to look good, feel good, have good skin, good hair, then you should take enough protein every single day. And And I understand that in the hostel it might not be feasible for you to, you know, reach your level of getting enough protein. Then you can have whey protein stored in your rooms. Whey protein is absolutely safe. There is a myth that it might contain steroids and all, but it's a myth. It's not right. You can have whey protein in your room. You can either have it with water or you can have it with milk. After exercising, it's one of the best meals that you can have. So you should exercise, lift heavy weights, start having more protein-rich diet so that you build more muscles, and that way your frame and structure will automatically look good.
Yeah? Firstly, thank you for the lovely lecture.
Thank you so much. He's just being honest, you guys are not.
Ma'am, my question is, people who are into regular weight training, it is said that they tend to put on a lot of weight once they take a break from it. Is it true, or if it's not, then why?
Okay. See, there are two things that even I hear often. That is, when I stop exercising, my muscles turn into fat. Right? But fat and muscles are totally different issues. One can never turn into the other. That's one thing. Number two, when you stop weight training, yes. You know, you might look overweight. For instance, if my weight is 60 kg with more muscles, and if a girl who has more fat and she weighs the same, she's 60 kg, but she might look fat and I might look toned. It's because of the ratio of the muscles, muscle mass in your body. So obviously when you stop going to the gym, that is stop working out totally, then you tend to have more fat in your body. So yes, you will look bloated, you will look fat. So I would never say that stop exercising. You can change, if you don't want to do weight training, then you can pick up maybe tennis or go for swimming, but never stop exercising, because once you stop exercising, obviously it will show, because our body was not supposed to, you know, sit for so many hours. We are meant to move. So that's what you have to do.
Thank you.
Wow, finally, I saw girls.
Ma'am, I would like to know about your journey from being a fat girl to a National Certified Fitness Expert.
So basically, as in what do you want to know?
What inspired you and how you became like this, ma'am?
Okay. Became like this is a compliment, right? Okay. I was 86 kg when I was in college. I was really fat, and then when I was out with my niece and all, so people used to consider me more than my age. So at that age, this was my only motivation, that at least I would look my age. And then when I started searching, you know, how I should start reducing weight, then I encountered so many myths. For example, people giving you pills to reduce weight. For all those people who want to try those pills given by all those babas and babies, don't ever take those pills. They're really damaging. Then those machines where you just have to sleep and, you know, they move and you become thin. So I encountered all these things, but then I realized that it's only you have to move. No machine can actually help you reduce weight. So slowly and gradually I started understanding, you know, how I should go about it, and I actually did it. And then I felt that, you know, if I can help others also become the same, you know, get fit. Because no matter what degrees you have, no matter, you know, because fitness is something which money can't buy. It can never be influenced, it can never be borrowed, it can never be purchased. You have to move, you have to change your lifestyle, and fitness is a mind game. You have to change everything, like how you look at the world, how you look at yourself. And then only you can actually become what you are. So I went through that phase, and then I thought that why not share what I did with everyone. And lucky enough for me, I chose the platform of social media, and I started reaching out to people. When I began in 2010, I had 400 Facebook friends. I shared my story, people got inspired. I made a video, and today it has got over 1.5 million views online of my weight loss video. basically I've never put in a single rupee in investing or in making, you know, spreading the word. It was always been a word of mouth. When people got the results, they told their friends. So slowly and gradually today I'm connected to over 2 lakh people on Facebook via my page and all. And this is how I feel like, you know, this is, I feel like, why should I keep it to myself? Why not share it to the world? And that's what I'm doing. And basically I'm loving what I'm doing.